In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
There is boy child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day.
He is the Emmanuel, God with us.
And man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
You are listening to Christmastide Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Stay tuned.
Long time ago in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible said.
It is Sunday, the 7th of January, 2024. The Feast of Epiphany, the manifestation of our Lord. And with this feast, we come to the end of the Christmastide. Jesus has been revealed to us as somebody who came for everyone, for all of us. And so everyone must have access to Christ. Participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members: Edwin Chebet Baraka from Eldoret, Kenya, celebrating his 36th birthday today. Text for us the first reading: Annabel Akpong Okrof from Dodi Papase, Ghana. Text for us the responsorial psalm. Teza Zimba from Lusaka, Zambia. Text for us the second reading. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Dennis Odongo from Lodwar Diocese in Kenya. Let us pray. O God, who on this day revealed your only begotten Son to the nations by the guidance of a star, grant in your mercy that we who know you already by faith may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
First reading, the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. A reading from the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 60, verse 1 to 6. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For behold, darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the people. But the Lord will rise upon you, and his glory will be seen upon you. And the nation shall walk by your light, and the king in the brightness of your rising. Lift up your eyes round about and see. They all gather together. They come to you. Your sons shall come from far, and your daughters shall be carried in the arms. Then you shall see and be radiant. Your heart shall thrill and rejoice, because the abundance of the sea shall be turned to you. The wealth of the nation shall come to you. A multitude of camels shall cover you. The young camel of Midian and Ephah, all those from Sheva shall come. They shall bring gold and frankincense. They shall proclaim the praises of the Lord, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Psalm 72, verse 1 to 2. Verse 7 to 8, verse 10 to 11, verse 12 to 13, and our response is taken from Psalm 72, verse 11. And the response is, all nations on earth shall fall prostrate before you, O Lord.
All nations on earth shall fall prostrate before you, O Lord.
Fall, prostrate before you. judgment to the king, to a king's son your justice, that he may judge your people in justice, and your poor in right judgment.
All nations on earth shall fall.
Shall rule from sea to sea, from the river to the bounds of the earth.
All nations on earth shall fall, prostrate before you, Lord.
The kings of Tarshish and the islands shall pay him tribute. The kings of Sheba and Seba shall bring him gifts. Before him, all kings shall fall prostrate. All nations shall serve him.
All nations on earth shall fall.
Shall save the needy when they cry, the poor, and those who are helpless. He will have pity on the weak and the needy, and save the lives of the needy.
All nations on earth shall fall.
Second reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 2, 3a, 5 to 6. Brethren, I assume that you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for you, how the mystery was made known to me by the revelation, which was not made known to the sons of men in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit. That is how the Gentiles are fellow heir members of the same body and partakers of the promises in Christ Jesus through the gospel, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Gospel Acclamation. Matthew chapter 2, verse 2. Alleluia, amen. Alleluia, amen. Alleluia. Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, amen. You have seen his star in the east, and you have come to worship the Lord.
Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew chapter 2, verse 1 to 12. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and have come to worship him." When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for it is written by the prophet, 'And you, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who will govern my people Israel.'" Then Herod summoned the wise men secretly, and ascertained from them what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, that I too may come and worship him. When they had heard the king, they went their way, and behold, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy, and going into the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then opening their treasures, they offered him gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed to their own country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Happy Feast of Epiphany! Epiphany means manifestation, and I want to tell you, especially those of you who are following, listening to this word from Africa, Epiphany was first celebrated in Africa, in Egypt, where it replaced a pagan feast that celebrated the victory of light over darkness. If you see, we are in January. And as we get to January, there is more light coming up north here than it was in December, than it was in November. The peak of darkness was 21st of December. And so we are now getting out of darkness. And as we get out of darkness, there is victory of light over darkness. And so Epiphany was celebrated to mean the victory of light over darkness. And in the Eastern churches, Epiphany is combined with Christmas. They celebrate Christmas on a day like this. Why? Because they want to tell us the real Christmas was when Christ himself was revealed as the light of the world, as the star that shines in the darkness of our lives. And we see this theme well outlined in the first reading of today, which is in this context. The people of Israel had gone to exile in 587 BC, some in 597 BC, and that exile was a moment of darkness for Jerusalem. Remember, Jerusalem was the center of worship. Jerusalem was a place where every Jew drew light from. It was the center of worship. That's why we see in Psalm 137 verse 5, the psalmist saying, "If I forget you, O Jerusalem, let my right hand wither, let it stop functioning." Because you are the source of strength, you are the source of inspiration, and that Jerusalem had to be restored. The Jerusalem that had become like a widow had to be restored, with the Lord promising to restore Zion by bringing back the exiles. These exiles were to come back not only as Jews, but they were to come back with the proselytes. They were to come back with those who had converted, who had become part of the people of Israel, the nations that were ready to join themselves to the Lord. Why? Because they saw something special in these people who were in exile. Their very presence converted the lives of people, and they wanted to come with them. They came with them. We see this prophesied by Zechariah in chapter 2, verse 11. On that day, many nations will join themselves to the Lord. I will live among you, and you will know that the Lord Almighty has sent me to you. The Lord will inherit Judah as his portion in the Holy Land, and will again choose Jerusalem. Jerusalem, the center of worship. Jerusalem, the reference point of whoever wants to know the Lord. And that Jerusalem was supposed to have light. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For behold, darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples, but the Lord will arise upon you. Who is this Lord arising upon them? The Lord arising upon them is the light that dispels the darkness that covers the earth. And this light will not only shine for a few people. No, it will shine for all nations. People are going to look up to Jerusalem whenever there is darkness. Why? Because darkness means confusion. When God was creating the world, the earth was all darkness and there was chaos. And the first thing God had to do was to proclaim, to make a declaration, let there be light. Yehiwa in Hebrew, let there be light. That's what God does. When there is confusion in the lives of people, God comes and says, let there be light. May they see the right course of action. May they see what they are supposed to be doing in their lives. Let there be light in the confusion the people are facing today. The confusion that has been caused by fiducia supplicants that is causing so many interpretations and misinterpretations because things are not very clear. And the certainty that is coming out through the categorical statements made by many bishops, especially in Africa and Asia, want to say the church to this day is still the Jerusalem from which light is drawn. People are looking up to this church, up to this Jerusalem, to get light for moral guidance, to know exactly how to live our gospel today, to know exactly how to live what God has asked us to in the Word of God. And the Lord is saying, rise, let there be light. Let your light shine for all nations, not for some nations, for all nations. The light that makes people follow the proper direction to Christ. The light that makes people not miss where Christ can be found. We're not even told about the number of those people, the Magi. These are ordinary people, not kings who were reading the signs of the skies. They were astrologers, so to say, who could look up in the sky and say, there is something there. There is a sign of something big. And they saw that sign and they got up to follow the sign. What sign was it? It was a star. And the star is only visible when it is dark. Oh yes, the star is Christ himself, the light. When we are facing darkness in our lives, when things are not clear in our lives, we turn to Christ, the light. We may even go to kings and ask them if they know where this light is found. Look at this politician they went to. They went to Herod, a politician. This king who knew little about how God operates was consulted. And they realized it was a wrong consultation. If you are looking for light, don't go to people who have selfish interest in something. You know, if I want my own agenda to be realized, I will surely advance my own interests. But when it comes to light, we don't advance our own interests. No, we make sure that we advance the interests of light. Because most of the time, our interests are all darkness. We are selfish human beings and we want to make sure that our deeds of darkness are the ones in front of us. but we are meant to be light. Remember, today is the Feast of Light. Remember, today we want to say we are exposing audits of darkness and we want to follow the light of Christ. Like the Magi, we want to go only in the direction of light, not in the direction of darkness. We have so many forces in our world today wanting to distract us from the truth, wanting to make us stray from the gospel that Christ himself has preached to us. We shouldn't pretend to be more merciful than Christ himself, trying to overrule what Christ has put in place. And we are listening to so many Herods. Look at the Magi. They did not listen to Herod. No, they knew his interests. Oh, when you go, tell me also that I may come to worship him. No, the interest of our Herods today is to kill Christ. The interest of our Herods today is to make sure Christ is nowhere in the picture, so that anything they want to do can be done. And so we see Christ being removed from our schools. No one is supposed to pray publicly in the school in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. No prayers are allowed in most of the schools, even some of the Christian schools. I love our Muslim brothers and sisters who remain adamant. They want to make sure the Quran is followed by anyone who goes to their school. In our Christian schools, especially in our Catholic schools, I don't know how many times we have mass in a week or in a month or in 2 months. I don't know. Maybe just at the opening of the school and the closing of the school and all the other days, we don't even think about Christ. Like one school in Lusaka, Zambia, and maybe other schools as well, like Maria Goretti in Moshi, Tanzania, where I used to go to meet the young people there. They have mass every day. I love other schools like Mary Immaculate Secondary School in Lusaka, Zambia, where the children have mass every day to remind them, listen, Christ is the light of this school, and he remains the light for anyone who comes to this school. You have to start with prayer. Why? Because he is the light. He is the one to guide our young people in the path of life, and we are not going to compromise just for political correctness. No! We will still maintain that Jerusalem, the church, is the light of the world, and Epiphany will make sense in our world today. Because we want Christ's light to be shown in our lives. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Sunday to you, and happy Feast of Epiphany.
Thanks be to God.
There is boy child, Jesus Christ was born on Christmas Day. Hark now, hear the angels sing, a king was born today. Christmas Day. There is boy child, Jesus.